Hey everyone, it's Dane again. Tonight we're in part 3 of our GBA Boxy Pixel build. We're going to be putting our IPS LCD panel in, so let's get to it. Okay, so here you can see we have our new IPS LCD. We have the bracket that it's going to sit in inside the shell, and this is the ribbon cable. Now there's a lot going on here, so it's definitely something we want to be careful with. And the first step here is that we are just going to attach this point right here. There's a small attach point that's going to hook up to this part here. So that is the first thing we're going to do. And I'll probably just kind of try to set this down on there on the top. You'll feel it kind of click into place. That's simple. All lined up. All right, next we are going to actually put our screen inside the shell here. And this is one of the parts that always makes me nervous. So the first thing we have to do is take this screen protector off here, and you can probably see that it has even, you know, just coming in the package, it's gotten some marks on there. So when you're handling one of these, you really wanna do your best not to touch the screen once you remove the protector, because that's actually gonna go under the glass that we're gonna put on the outside of this eventually. And so if any dust, fingerprints, or anything like that is on there, once the glass is on, you'd have to disassemble the entire thing to get it back out. So we want to avoid that. So just something to keep in mind as we're working on it here. All right, removing our protector. There we go. All right, so we're gonna just flip this over and support that ribbon cable as we do it. And it's pretty stiff, so we don't have to worry about that too bad. And actually this silicone pad's kind of getting in the way, so we're just gonna remove that. And then really we want to push this up and to the left, and then fold our ribbon cable up. It's going to sit in here, something like this kind of eventually. Now, good thing we have this bracket, because as you can see, there is a little bit of wiggle room in here for this. So our next step is going to be to set this bracket in here. So we really kind of secure everything in place, just like that. Now this came with a foam insert here, so we're going to use that. That goes right on the back of the screen here. I may have to trim this up a little bit. We'll see here in a minute. All right, we're good for now. I think I'm gonna go mess with this, see if I can get that to fit in there a little bit better, and I'll be right back. All right, we're not gonna worry about the foam for the back of the screen right now. We've got other stuff we need to do anyway. So looking at this, a couple things come to mind. One, this ribbon cable does need to sit down kind of inside the housing here. So just something to keep in mind when you're working on one of these, that this top area does need to fit down under this little lip right here. Now, unfortunately for me, the motherboard that I have here has a smaller connector, so I can't use the easy to access end up here. I have to use this smaller end down here. I'm gonna actually have to flip that up and connect it here when I'm ready to go. So it means a couple of things. You know, I'm just gonna have to be really careful, because as you can see, there are two traces. Actually, yeah, you can see it there. So there are two traces that run through this section here, and we have to be very sure not to damage them. So yeah, this is definitely gonna be a little tricky, but it's doable, you know? We just, with stuff like this, we always just kind of have to take our time, go slow, be careful. So that is something that, you know, that's a bridge I'm gonna have to cross when I get to it. Now, the other thing I was thinking about is my speaker. I probably should get this into place now, you know, so I make sure it's not rattling or anything like that, so that when I start, you know, putting the motherboard in here, trying to arrange the power circuit and the audio amp, that is already ready to go and I don't have to mess with it. So I think I'll just be routing the wires up the side like this. So I think what I'm gonna do to get this to stick is really just try to put a little bit of Gorilla tape on the outside of this and try to kind of get it to stick. probably to the floor here, maybe to the edge a little bit. And I'll tell you, this double-sided Gorilla Tape has come in really handy for me. You know, if you need something to stay really flat, you don't want to use it, but if you need something to kind of take up space, this stuff is great. Actually, I need some scissors. So I'm going to try cutting some thin strips of this, because what I don't want to do is have this covering up in the front of the speaker. You know, it's okay if it kind of sticks to this edge here, or the outer edge, but I really don't want to get in front of the speaker at all there. I should be able to do that a little bit better down in this corner. Use my trusty tweezers for this. I'm actually going to custom cut this just a little bit. There we go. Right then. Now, once this is stuck down in there, it's going to be really hard to get this top removed, so I'm just going to try to do that right now. Sometimes it's easier said than done with this stuff. There's one piece. Really, I could have done this before installing the screen. In fact, I could pop the whole thing out if I wanted to, but this won't really interfere with it at all. Should be able to get a couple of strips out of this piece here. That's pretty good and thin. I'm gonna try to thin it up just a little bit more here, but it's kind of tricky. Heck, that peeled it and everything. Started. There we go. This piece is being so stubborn. There we go. I think one more small piece ought to do it. Just set that down in. There we go. And that did give it a bit of extra height, but I really don't think it's any higher than the back of the original speaker would be, so. Hopefully that doesn't cause any issues. The nice thing though is like that speaker is not gonna rattle around in there at all. That is solid as a rock. Okay, I think next we're going to go ahead and tin our pads on the flex cable here. Now, I usually keep my iron set to like 330 C. You know, it's not crazy hot or anything. You know, with stuff like this, I really don't want to mess the board up. So we're going to be fast with this. And in general, I don't really like working inside of the case. I try not to do it too much. So here, I'm just going to have to be fast, but careful, you know. Not rushing, just, you know, kind of keeping in mind that time is kind of the essence here with this. So I'll grab my solder here. My iron is already to temperature. I'll flip on my fume extractor. Simple. So you can see that I wasn't rushing, you know, just making sure that there's just enough time to get that solder to attach to that point. And now we will be able to attach all of our wires to that ribbon cable, no problem. All right, so I'm going to go check my reference sheet for what wires need to go where and how exactly I'm going to start hooking everything up to our motherboard here, and I will be right back. All right, so according to my instructions, we're really only going to be using three of those solder pads. Now I did all four of them, but that's no big deal. So we have ground at the top, select, and then right and left. Now we are going to use select, right, and left. The first thing we actually need to do is prepare our board, because we need a TP2, which is this very small pad right here. So, here we go. So TP2 is this spot right there. So you can see it's pretty small. It's not quite as small as some of these like really tiny SMD caps we've worked with, but still we're gonna wanna be, you know, careful when we're working on this. So same deal, we are going to tin this position, and then we're actually going to run a wire from it, because that is going to actually go to our select line here. Now, the screen that I bought, the Funnyplaying IPS LCD, actually came with wires for me that are already stripped. So I'll probably just go ahead and use these. I mean, I've got my own, so I don't really care, but hey, they're in there. So I'll go ahead and use them. But before I do all that, let's go ahead and get this TP2 pad ready to go. All right, so for this, I am gonna use just a little bit of flux. Should just help everything go a little more smoothly. Just a drop though, we really don't need much. Actually, you know what, I want just a little bit bigger bead on there than that. All right, so as you can see, it does leave a little bit of residue on the board, so we are just gonna clean that right now while we're going. Well, actually, you know what, we will do that after we attach our wire. And these must be like 32s. They are really, really small. They're even smaller than my Kynar wires. So sorry, this will be off camera, but all I'm doing is adding just a little bit of solder to a tiny wire. There's one side. There's the other. So for this, I think we're just going to basically lay it right there and weld it into place. Now I'm right-handed, so I'm actually going to flip this. Really, all I should have to do is just barely touch it. You know what? That's attached, but I want a little bit better connection. I'm gonna do just a little bit more flux. I'm gonna put just a little bit of solder on my iron there. There we go. Much better. Again, you can see I'm being fast with it, just because we don't want to scorch anything. And I'll show you what that looks like up close. So that is a really good connection there. It's not going anywhere. And I'm just going to clean that while I'm here. Not quite as clean as I want it. This is on there too stiff. A little more alcohol. Much better. Because I've got this screen facing down, even though it's up inside the shell, I really want to keep my mat clean of debris. And you'd be amazed at how quickly just dust and skin cells and stuff like that gets on your mats. This will eventually be sitting down in here like this. Which actually means that my wire doesn't have all that far to run, which is good. And then I think the next thing I need to do is actually equip my wires here. So I'm going to check my reference again just to double check. You know, it's always good to measure twice, cut once, and check that. And I'll be right back. Okay, so you can see that I've just set my PCB above my shell, because once this thing gets hooked up, we're basically gonna be setting it in there like that. So the next thing I'm gonna do is hook my wires up to this And then I have to figure out how I'm going to hook this up, because I have a feeling that's going to be a challenge. The other thing I need to do is run my wires for my shoulder buttons. And in this case, you know, it's marked as right. And, you know, your instinct might be like, oh, this is my right side, so I want to run the R this way. But it's referring to the right shoulder button, which is opposite, because we have this thing turned around. So, okay, well, apparently that wire fell into another dimension entirely, so I had to cut and strip a brand new one. But that is no big deal. Frankly, I don't really like using all the same color wires anyway. Just at a glance, it makes it harder to tell what's what, so I tend to prefer having all my wires be a different color anyway. But yeah, that's no big deal. Alright, so one of the next things we need to do is put some captain tape on this upper portion, which we will not be using. Be careful doing that. This ribbon cable is a lot springier than you would actually expect. Let's move that back into place. Bracket back. There we go. That's making me nervous doing that. I think I'm going to use my side snips instead. That will do. So let's go ahead and attach our left and right wires. So again, right is going to be on our left side, left is going to be on our right side. And I think I'm even going to pretin my wire just a bit. I'm sorry, pretin my iron. Should just make this all go a little easier. That's all there is to it. You can see I touched it for like half a second. Now on this one that I cut, you can see that my leads are maybe a little longer than they ought to be, so I'm just gonna trim those down so we don't have a bunch of extra wire hanging around that we don't need. All right, now we'll do our left side. Yeah, it's pre-tuned there. There we go. So now our ribbon cable should be good. Okay, let's see about hooking up our ribbon cable and our select line. All right, so I know that basically this has to bend up this way here, which I think means that then this bends back this way to connect. All right, so I'm gonna put a little captain tape on here just to provide some strain relief for that solder pad. And bend it this way, make sure it's out of the way. There we go, it should keep this from pulling on that pad. So pretty much that is gonna plug in right there, like so. Which kind of just makes me wanna run this line right up here. Yeah, you know, I think honestly, I'm just gonna kind of set this here. In fact, I may even just go ahead and hook this up here first, because really all that's gonna be happening is this is going to be bending up kind of back on itself this way. And actually, I'm gonna need to bend this guy kind of back in on itself anyway. So yeah, I think I'm actually just going to install this side first. In there as it's going to get. Alright, so that is in place. Now it looks a little ugly at the moment, but it's going to be good to go before we know. Alright, so next let's hook up our select line. And we will pre-tin our iron. There we go, just like that. Okay, so now I'm going to fold this guy on top since we're not using it. And then we're going to push everything else up run our wires up here. Okay, this is starting to look like something. I'm going to bring this line over this way. It's going to weave some of these wires down just a bit. There we go, much better. Got access to my speaker wires right here on the side. So I think this is now ready to secure in place. Let's take a quick peek at the other side. A little bit of dust on there, a couple teeny tiny fingerprints we'll take care of in a bit. All right, now I need the actual screws. Phillips head screws in here, not my tri-wings. There we go. There's the screws. Alright, so you kind of have to lift the whole thing up because if you have the thing sitting down on your bench, the buttons will actually push the PCB back up. We'll do this one first. Alright, there's one side. And now. Yeah, this side is just fighting me a little bit. I think these screws are used to being down in plastic, not in aluminum. I am a little worried about this one cross threading. Oh yeah, that's starting to strip out on me. That's no good. Let's see if I've got any extra small screws in here. Let's see if maybe this one will do the job. Here we go. Yeah, there was just something up with this screw. It was not cooperating with me. Okay, so we have our screen hooked up, our wires ready to run for our shoulder buttons. The buttons are working. All right, that stuff all feels pretty good. Cool. You know, I checked again on the foam thing in the instructions, and they said to put this under, but they didn't actually do it anywhere. So I'm not gonna worry about it myself. Nothing looks like it's gonna get down in there or anything. So I'll only worry about that if something else comes up. So now we get to start thinking about our power and our audio. We know that our power board is going to fit in here like this. And we did cut our channel for our wires for our audio amp, which we are planning to put right there. So, you know, to me, this all looks pretty good. Looks like it's gonna fit. I think really the trickiest part is just gonna be routing wires from the points on the motherboard that we need to weld to here, here. And of course our wires here, which we do need to tin. I'm going to bend those over so we remember we need to tin those. But yeah, we're moving right along. The other thing we have is we have a little diode here that is going to have to hook up to this position pretty soon here. But yeah, once we do that, we're done. Like, once we get this part wired up, we are going to be ready to test this thing out. I'm getting excited. We're not too far off now.